Hey, aloha. Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. Happy not just keeping the law, which was the law of Moses, but making holy the day, not because of its obligation, but because it's good for my soul. We are a sanctuary. You know, in the times of Judaism, early Judaism, a sanctuary was an object. A kingdom was a place. A king was a title of power. And Jesus did not, as a Jew, come to start his own religion, by the way. He didn't come to start his own 501c3. He came to continue it, to grow. There's the more of God and the more of what kingdom is and the more of what kingship is. And it was coming from the external to the internal, from the exclusive to the inclusive. Now, right there is huge things to think about. In a dualistic world, there is only exterior, interior. There is only you're part of the king or you're a pauper, you know? But in Jesus, it's the both and. It's this dualistic thinking that's killing us. Jesus is saying it's both and. Yeah, all lives matter. But right now, as white lives have mattered, now we're recognizing, finally, maybe, that black lives matter as well, not only black lives matter, so therefore white go away. But if you're a dualistic thinker, that's all you're thinking about. And if all you know is white or pink or purple and another comes in, well, that's a threat. And Jesus came to take away all that stuff, to make it more natural, you see. A sanctuary. And that's why instead of the temple, Jesus says, we're the temple. Instead of Jerusalem over there, we're the new Jerusalem. So let's begin now our celebration of love, of becoming, and truly asking ourselves as we admire a sanctuary from afar is beautiful, do people look at our actions and recognize that we too are sanctuaries, that we are holding the Spirit of God just as much as any tabernacle or church whose doors are open, who maybe they should be closed, but our sanctuary inside is always open. Let's get ready. I invite you all who are here to have some bread and wine or cracker or juice with you, with your loved ones. You can break bread and drink of the cup with me, as I am really believing I am doing with you.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and the peace of God our Father, and of the Lord Jesus, in you, from you, be with you always. Thank you. I hope you blessed me back and said, and with your Spirit as well. Because without that connection, we have no life. Without our being connected to each other, we don't have as much life. And sometimes it's our own sense of independence, as we celebrate this Independence Day, that we really think that we can get by without others, and we store our corn in a barn because when we starve, will we really trust that our next door neighbor will help us and feed us? So let's become people of mercy, not a temple set on a hill for all to look at, but a temple where people can come and say, I need the God in you to be for me. So I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have seriously sinned in my thoughts and my words and what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my fault, not your fault. Through my fault, not your fault. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God and Almighty God. Let us have mercy on us. Gives us our sins and leads us to life everlasting. Amen. Isn't that great? Imagine being able to start again, to recognize our lack, not as a condemnation, but as an invitation to be filled. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Father, Lord, you are the light of all that is truth. Truth, not what correct, not what is correct, but truth. Especially to those of us who know that we've gone astray and we're looking for guidance. If we're not looking for guidance, we don't care. Right? So that we may return to the right path, which is available and accessible, though we limit it. And give us all, for the faith we profess, as accounted Christians, a grace to reject whatever is contrary to your love that we hear of in the gospel. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, my lovelies, our first reading is from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, which was great because that's not what the reading is. How about that? See, this is called a liturgical blooper. Here we go. A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. My bad. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. Your king shall come to you. I'll be your savior. Worry no more. But he'll be meek, riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He'll banish the mighty chariot from Ephraim and the mighty horse from Jerusalem, even though meek. The warrior's bow shall be banished. And he shall proclaim peace to all nations, not just that nation. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The Gospel. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So sing, O daughter Zion. Let's now have a song, which actually is a song, in which the days of old people remembered all the things that the Lord had done to their people in a good way, not just in loss, but in being found. How can I help but proclaim that and sing that?
My life flows on in heavenly song.
storm can shake my inmost heart. But to that rock I'm clinging, since love prevails in heaven and earth.
How can I keep from sinning?
From the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. My brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit. If only the Spirit of God you would allow to dwell in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ doesn't belong by their choice. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh. To live according to the flesh, we will die. But if by the Spirit, even if we're put to death, the deeds of the body will live on. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Of the Spirit. When the flesh dies, we go to a funeral. What do we hear about? The deceased spirit. But he did. See? We don't talk about his looks or his money, I hope. Talk about the Spirit, the good things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Gospel. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the learned and the clever, you have revealed them to the little ones, the merest children. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. And no one knows the Son as much except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son. And anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal himself. So listen, come to me, all you who are labor and are burdened, who need help. I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am meek and humble of heart. For you will find rest for yourselves. My yoke is easy, my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You know, I've always been haunted by that. You know, Lord, you hid things from the learned and the clever, but you revealed them to the merest children. And here I am. I've had probably 20 years of Catholic school, 8 years of scripture studies and academics, especially towards priesthood academics. So there was spiritual formation, and there was ministry formation, and there was the apostolate, etc. But it was basically academic. And even today, when we think of church and church teachings, it's academic. It appears academic, one dimension. And actually, in studying scripture, there is an actual method to the madness. You know, there, you look at the time that the writer of the scripture was writing in. You look at the people he was talking to. You get to learn where they were at, and therefore he addresses himself to their situation. God addresses himself through the writer to their situation. So what we hear from the Gospel of Matthew, you're not going to hear from the Gospel of Mark because they're written to two different people. In Matthew's Gospel, we're talking to not just Jewish converts to Christianity, not a formal religion at the time, but a way of living, a life, a new way of freedom. And we hear that Jesus is inviting not just the academics, the rabbis, and the scripture scholars, but the merest, the Gentile, who's probably more accessible to what Jesus is offering them than the learned and the clever. God doesn't hide that from the learned and the clever, but the learned and the clever find self-sufficiency in what they know. And there's a vulnerability in the meekness and in the vulnerable when you do want. You admit that you're lost, because in my want I have need. In my lost I wish to be found. So it's the Gentile. It's the woman. It's the outsider. It's all those people who have been told their lives do not matter. And it's not their fault. It was just the social context that they were thrown in. And Jesus says, I want you. The learned and clever, you're welcome. Not a problem. But don't exclude how we're going to own this thing. We're human beings. The intellect is what makes us different from animals. We're human beings. We need to wonder. We need to ponder. But it's the distractions of the flesh that Paul talks about that gets in our way. And what exactly would we say are the distractions of the flesh? I wrote them down. Well, I didn't write them down. I stole them from this little book here. And it says, we are blocking ourselves from the miracle. Because all of us here in the West, we're born into a culture that is addicted to power. We're addicted to prestige, control, money, acquiring, approval, security, violence, sensation, feeling, pleasure, busyness, doing, and the list goes on and on. And those things of the flesh do block out the spirit. So God ain't holding back. We're just not putting ourselves out there. Meister Eckhart, who was once accused of being a heretic, now he's in good graces, thank God. Meister Eckhart said that our faith is not about addition, but subtraction. It's not about doing, 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 acquiring, 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 building, building, building. It's not about adding things. It's about subtraction. God does not hold back. He is infinitely in front of us. Love is infinitely in front of us. Hope is infinitely in front of us. Mercy is infinitely in front of us. Freedom is infinitely in front of us. But we have to subtract all the stuff I just listed to get at it. So it's put ourselves in silence every day. Do we do that? Just for 2 minutes. 2 minutes and listening. Listening to what's going on in here. But it'll take 15 minutes just to quiet down. And we have to quiet down to be in touch with the Spirit. So if you're disgruntled, probably a very good reason to be. But it's usually people are disgruntled from people who are not to be the abusers, but the freedom seekers. But they leave out those people. The Gentile. The little one. So, God bless us all. God bless you all as we continue our Eucharist together. Let us pray. First of all, renew our baptismal promises. This is like what you do before you vote. You know, you have to really ask yourself these vows in your decision making. Do you reject Satan and all his empty promises and all his lies and sin? I do. Do you believe in what it means to believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth? I do. Do you believe in what it means to believe in Jesus, his Son, our Christ, born of Mary, in the flesh, raised by Mary and Joseph, and who endured suffering, who died, was buried? I do. Do you believe in who we are in the Holy Spirit? A universal church meant to be connected to everyone, all life, plant, animal, ocean, human. I do. This is our faith life, not our flesh life, that we have to give priority to in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Our prayer. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. Pray for all of you, and I thank you for all your prayers for me and all your actions for the little ones in Kenya, in Haiti, and now a little orphanage on the border that was attacked the other night. We pray for lightening of angers in our world and the release of mercy and kindness. And we pray for those who really have it hard. You know, I'm thinking, I can pray for love, for mercy and kindness, but I don't have a gun to my head. I'm not told I can't have education. I'm not told I'm told I can't get this job, or I don't deserve as much as this guy or this gal because I'm not a guy or a gal. For them who will find it's really harder to live these realities because of the abuses of the flesh inflicted on them. I pray for them. We pray to the Lord. Thanksgiving. For education, that is a luxury. Electricity, that's a luxury. I pray for the opportunities that I have had and we have had because of where we live or what color we are, or our being nurtured or not nurtured in childhood. I pray for us all. I pray that I may not just pray for myself. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all those who take care of the sick, and for all those who are sick with this virus, this growing virus, and that we may take the simplicity of not medicine, academics, but of just common sense. Wear the mask. Jeez, please. Get over yourself. Uh-oh. Pray to the Lord. So, loving Father, thank you for the opportunities you've given us. May we come to love you in all things. In Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen. I'm a young black man doing all that I can to stand. Oh, but when I look around and I see what's being done to my kind. Every day, I'm being hunted as prey. My people don't want no trouble. We've had enough struggle. I just wanna live. God, protect me. I just wanna live. I just wanna live.
I'm doing nothing but having a peaceful protest. Here we go.
One day more, another day, another destiny. This never-ending road to Calvary. These men who seem to
be
will surely come a second time. One day more.
How can I live when we are apart?
One day more.
With you, one more
day. One more day on my own.
Will we ever meet again?
One more day with him, no caring.
I was born to be with you.
What a life I might have known.
And I swear I will be true.
But he
freedom.
Shall I join my brother
when our reigns begin to fall?
Do I stand
when you take your place with me? One day more,
one more day to revolution. We will nip it in the bud. We'll be ready for these schoolboys. They will wet them someday more.
Watch them run amok, catch them as they fall. Never know your luck when there's a free for all. Here a little dip, there a little touch. Most of them are gone, so they won't miss much.
One day to a new beginning.
In America, freedom.
In America, be a king.
If you want to make a king,
who's true? Who's
free?
Who's
true?
Who's true?
My place is here, I fight with you. One day more,
I will join these people's heroes. I will follow where they go. I will learn their little secrets. And I will know them
one day more.
Tomorrow is the judgment day.
Tomorrow we'll discover what our God in heaven has in store. One more dawn, one more day, one day.
No, I wasn't out taking the collection. Had to readjust myself. How about that? Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread and wine to offer you. Which earth is given you in hands of may be become for us the bread of life and the cup of salvation. Blessed be God. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sins. Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that your lives and mine, your gifts and mine, may be accepted by God, our loving Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at my hands, at our hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. So, Father, we've come to you now humble and hungry, not for the filling of our stomach or the quenching of our physical thirst, but for the love and kindness we seek and need in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lord, you are holy indeed and the fountain of all holiness. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, our passion,
took himself in bread, and he gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke himself in the bread, giving himself to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Supper was ended. He took the cup again, giving you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples, and he said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, O Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. So as we celebrate the memorial of Christ's life, death, and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister you. Humbly, we pray now that in partaking of the life and the bounty of our Lord Jesus Christ, may we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember who we are to become throughout the world as a church. Bring us to the fullness of charity. That's the ultimate power that we seek, is to be charitable, filled with mercy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have died in the peace of Christ. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on all of us, we pray, O Lord, that when we come together with Mother Mary and Joseph and all your saints, we may praise and glorify you because of them and all the love we received in this life, as is Christ our Lord. Because in that love, it is through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, that all glory and honor is yours and ours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. So we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth and on the journey to heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and that daily bread I am to share. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who've wronged us. It's tough to let go of those things. Which is why we ask your help to lead us not into the temptation and the grudge, but deliver us from evil. Amen. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. So the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's prepare to be Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who receive him. O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. And the blood of Kolohe, the body of Christ. The body of Christ, Kolohe. All right, go back to sleep. Let's take a moment.
All the places.
his shame wrote our story. You're giving us your memory. It's not just perspective, it's innocence restored. Jesus. You don't give your heart. You don't hide yourself, Jesus.
Father, in word and Eucharist and prayer, we've been together. At home, we're together. May we feel your presence, your support, and may we plug into you as the ultimate of power when all is said and done, and not wait till the last minute on our deathbed saying, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Be at peace now, and be the light of Christ to the world. And to that we say, thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, we pray.